Hello to everyone watching this footage, it's Leviathan here again, and to start things off I'm going to introduce myself to newcomers. I'm born high-functioning autistic, I'm obsessed with fiction, and I'm planning to make my own creative universe like how the late Stan Lee did for his. For this particular footage, I'm going to introduce three new characters. And if you guys could bear with me as I describe them to you, I hope it would be satisfactory for you guys. Here it is. Here's the first character. Hue Girl. Real name, Maya Norell. Length, 7 feet 6 inches. Weight, 334 pounds. Status, hero, and descendant of Quetzalcoatl. Base, Central America, mobile. Intelligence, 3 brains to 4 brains. Behavior. Sneaky, cunning, and protective. She'll do anything to honor the existence of her legendary ancestor. Lethality. Only if you violate her ancestor. Weaknesses. Gunpowder. Powers. She possesses a long serpentine tail and a pair of feathered wings, all in vibrant colors. She can summon 2 kinds of feathered snakes. The wing snakes that are venomous, and the wingless snakes that are constrictors. She also possesses extreme wisdom. Eyes, vivid yellow and green. Hair, strawberry blonde and wavy. Origin. Maya Norell was once an archaeologist who always wanted to explore Central America. At one point, she fell into an undiscovered tomb that happened to be the shrine of the feathered serpent god Quetzalcoatl. At the end of the shrine was an ancient wall painting of Quetzalcoatl. And when Maya looked at the serpent god for a few seconds, the eyes of the creature zapped a red beam into her eyes, knocking her out. When she awoke, she found that she's forever transformed into Q-Girl, a more humanoid version of Quetzalcoatl, who just so happens to be her long-lost ancestor. Since then, Q-Girl will honor her ancestor and will destroy anyone who violates him. Costume. She has a series of vibrant colored feathers for a top. Team, solitary or with other heroes. Original inspiration, Quetzalcoatl of Mesoamerican mythology. Here's the next character to introduce. Radona. Real name unknown. Height, 5 feet 9 inches. Weight, 149.5 pounds. Status, villain and servant of Valkyrie. Base, Germany. Mobile. Intelligence, 3 brains. Behavior, nasty, torturous, and stubborn. She'll do anything to destroy the Americans, no matter the cost. Lethality, extremely lethal to all those in her presence. Weaknesses, she is severely flammable. Powers. She can enable the power to radiate with Adolph-X gases, which could kill most mortals. She can also enable the ability to mutate any organism through physical contact. Eyes, deep black. Hair, deep black and ratty. Origin. One time, there was a common German woman who was captured and experimented on by the genocidal Valkyrie in an attempt to annihilate the United States. After the sinister procedure, the woman developed the ability to radiate herself with deadly and virulent Adolph-X gases. When the patriotic Star Spangler attempted to foil their new attempt, she got weakened when Radona enabled her gases and was almost killed. Luckily, the rest of the Patriots 3 had rescued the Star Spangler and defeated both of the tyrants in a long fight. Since then, Radona chose to be an eternal servant for Valerie, even if it costs her life. Valkyrie and such. Costume. She simply wears nothing official. Teams, solitary, works for Valkyrie and other villains. Original inspiration, radiation. The last one is not much of a character per se, but a species, a creature. And here it is. Sabercroc. Real name, inapplicable. Length, 35 feet, weight 575 pounds, status, villain, and creation of Dr. Scream, base, mobile, intelligence, 3 brains, behavior, savage and destructive, it always enjoys the feral hunt, lethality, only when craving or during a fight, weaknesses, explosions, and stab wounds, powers, it possesses the head of a Smilodon and the body of a crocodile, along with having all the powers of both organisms. Eyes, blood red. Hair, tannish gold and scruffy. Origin. One time, Dr. Scream decided that she would create a creature that is a biological cross between a Smilodon and a crocodile. After being given the name Sabercroc, it was commanded to go out and kill those vacationing along the beaches of Hawaii. Eventually, Sabercroc ended up fighting a mutant gator, which it finally killed and devoured. Partially pleased of this accomplishment, Scream decided to fully recover the mutant gator for future use. Costume, none. Teams, solitary, for Dr. Scream and other creatures. Origin exploration, Smilodons and crocodiles. Well, I hope you guys like those three new themes. And right now, I'm planning to change my scheduling from one video every 2 weeks to one video every 1 week. I just hope that it would help me out when it comes to patience and also when it comes to diversity and social flourishment and such, if that's the right way to put it. So if you guys have any more comments and questions, you could comment down below. It's your choice. You could also like and subscribe. It's your choice after all. It's all on you. And hope you guys have a fine last day of February, and hopefully you guys would have a fine March and such. And I'm Leviathan. Hope you guys have a fine time, and until next time, in transmission.